Hi, this is Aarti Chhabria and you are watching Viral Bollywood. Thanks for
coming. Thank you.
Come look here. Yeah, look here. Ma'am here. Here, ma'am. Yeah.
Yeah, to look.
Hey guys, listen, I'm so sorry. We'll have to do this.
Yeah, yeah.
Not now.
I was in New York Film Academy chale gaye in New York to study filmmaking and I graduated as director there. और उसके बाद मैंने सोचा कि जब मैं वापस आऊँगी तो मुझे अपने कल्चर के ऊपर हमारे इंडिया के ऊपर कोई अच्छा एक सब्जेक्ट लेकर एक शॉर्ट फिल्म बनाना चाहिए. दैट्स हाउ वी स्टार्टेड लुकिंग एट स्क्रिप्ट्स एंड वी केम अप विद मुंबई वाराणसी एक्सप्रेस. आई एम हियर विद द लवली टीम, द कास्ट ऑफ माई फिल्म, द मेन कास्ट ऑफ माई फिल्म. तो मैं ज़्यादा नहीं कहूँगी, आई पास द माइक ऑन टू the man, the lovely actor who played Krishna Kant Jhunjhunwala in a film, Darshan Zariwala ji.
That's because Vivek, Shekhar, we all know what tremendous odds this shooting of this film in Varanasi has really taken out of us. You know, at what level we have worked, and I'm immensely happy today to have seen this labor of love, because and if it weren't for Aarti's dedication and absolute commitment to the film, this film wasn't possible. None of us. I'm absolutely clear on this. You take Aarti away and the film is not there. It is only because I have seen the way she has worked. I have seen the way she has every day battled against odds and made this film happen. And I and Shekhar were just reminiscing about the tremendous elements that we had to face, the crowds that we had to negotiate, the you see, it's very difficult to shoot in India. I now know this because I've shot in many other places since past 1 year in the world. And I realize every day, whenever I'm shooting abroad, how impossible it is to shoot in this country. This country that says Atithi Devo Bhava is so hostile to any filmmaking in this country, especially, I mean, even taking note of the fact that Uttar Pradesh is the most film-friendly state, it has been given that award this time, yet, and those odds were insurmountable, except when Aarti decided to surmount them, and she did it, and I'm absolutely thrilled that I'm a part of this film. And what else can I say? I mean, sharing private thoughts in a public place is an actor's delight, but I really love you. And it's great. I mean, if this is the beginning, aagaaz to acha hai, lekin anjaam to mashallah rahega. That's what I feel. Thank you so much. Thank you for this film, Aarti.
Thank you for such kind words. They mean the world to me. I've been trying and trying hard to, you know, get his time to show him the film, but he's been very, very busy and he's highly in demand. He's in every other fantastic Bollywood film. He's moving to Hollywood as well. He's already won a national award and he's also been a part of a Million Dollar Arm, which was another Hollywood film. So, in spite of my constant effort for showing him the film, this is the first time that he's actually viewed our film with full sound and music and all of that. So thank you for making it today and thank you for your kind words. Very encouraging, and at a point where, you know, only very few people connected to the film know what this film has been through to come, you know, to come together. So thank you, Darshanji, for everything that you've just said. I love you too, and in future if I make anything, I would definitely want you to be a part of it because you've been so cooperative, so cooperative. Yes, apart from that, of course, we have two more lovely actors with us, Shekhar ji who has played the role of Satish Sutaria from Surat in our film. And, you know, we shot in a studio in Bombay at Lakshmi Studios because we would not get permission to shoot in the train. Train mein shooting karne ke liye aapko minimum 10 lakh dena padta hai as permission. और वो मेरे पास वो पैसे थे नहीं ये सीन शूट करने के लिए तो हमें एक सेट पे ये पूरी शूटिंग करनी पड़ी और फिर जो बैकग्राउंड्स हम लोगों ने डाले वो VFX पोस्ट प्रोडक्शन पे में डाले गए तो इट वाज नॉट इजी बट आई वुड लाइक टू पास ऑन द माइक नाउ टू शेखर जी टू से अ फ्यू वर्ड्स
सबसे पहले तो थैंक यू वेरी मच टू दर्शन जरीवाला एंड आरती जी क्योंकि कुछ नाम माने कि शेखर शुक्ला का नाम कहीं से भी पास हुआ था आई थिंक सो दर्शन जी की ओर से और आरती जी ने मुझे कास्ट किया एक बार हुआ था डेट हुई थी लेकिन पोस्टपोन हुई उसके बाद थोड़ी तकलीफ हो गई थी आगे के लिए लेकिन फिर भी अगेन जब शूटिंग डेट कंफर्म हुई और डन हुआ तो मुझे ऐसा लग रहा है कि वो अच्छा दिन था कि मेरे साथ ये सब कुछ एडजस्टमेंट हो गया और ये रोल मैंने किया क्या बात है बहुत अच्छे आती जी आपने कंसीव बहुत ही अच्छा किया है कंपेरिजन वाइज जिसे कहे सूरत नु जमन ने काशी नु मरण नो डाउट स्टोरी दर्शन जी की है टोटली लेकिन फिर भी आपने यूज किया ये कैरेक्टर यहाँ से जो शुरुआत होती है अरे भैया खाओ पियो मजा करो टोटली और वहाँ पे जाके वो अच्छे हुए भी लेकिन देखो मौत कहाँ लिखी थी जो भी है लेकिन बहुत ही मजा है शूट करने का बाकी टोटल जो दर्शन जी ने अंग्रेजी में कहा है वही सब कुछ मैं हिंदी में कहना चाहता हूँ बहुत मजा आया आरती जी के साथ काम करने का पहली बार मैं मिला उनसे पहली बार उनके डायरेक्शन में काम किया काफी लोगों के साथ काम किया डायरेक्शन में लेकिन यहाँ पे कुछ नया एक गर्ल लेडीज के साथ काम करना मुझे कास्ट किया और क्या बात है भाई साहब बहुत बढ़िया हम लोग मिले नहीं है लेकिन क्योंकि आप वाराणसी में थे बम्बई में थे लेकिन बहुत ही अच्छा काम किया आपने धन्यवाद थैंक यू वेरी मच
थैंक यू सो मच विवेक ये स्पेशली आए हैं ट्रेन पकड़कर वाराणसी से हमारे साथ यहाँ जुड़ने के लिए मुंबई एंड ही कम स्पेशली फ्रॉम वाराणसी जस्ट टू वॉच द फिल्म एंड बी विद ऑल ऑफ अस सो इट्स अ वेरी स्पेशल डे फॉर हिम आल्सो बिकॉज इट्स हिज फर्स्ट शॉर्ट फिल्म व्हिच इज रिलीजिंग ऑनलाइन एंड आई थिंक ही इज डन अ फैब जॉब एंड इट्स अ वेरी स्ट्रॉन्ग रोल एंड आई नीडेड समवन यू नो टू प्ले रफीक यू नो अ मुस्लिम कैरेक्टर विद You know, along with being a rickshawala, because saying the dialogues while riding the rickshaw was not an easy task. So, I will hand over the mic and I hope he can tell you about the effort that we put in together before shooting Rafiq's character.
This is a very big break and I want to thank you for saying that she gave me the opportunity. सबसे पहले मैम का फोन आया था फिर उन्होंने मुझे बोला कि ठीक है तुम आप कर सकते मैंने कहा हाँ मैम फिर मैम जब आई तो हम लोग तीन दिन चार दिन हम लोग लगातार इस पे कि रिक्शा भी चलाना है और बात भी करना है रिक्शा चलाना अपने आप में ही बहुत मुश्किल है जब आप चलाओगे तो आपको समझ में आएगा कितना टफ जॉब है खासकर जब ट्रैफिक में आप जाते हैं और उसके बाद उस कैरेक्टर को समझने में थोड़ी मेहनत की और मैम ने बहुत ज़्यादा मदद की और ऐसे कहते भी हैं कि फिल्म इज़ अ डायरेक्टर्स मीडियम तो ये सीधे सीधे यहाँ से प्रूफ होता है जो भी मैं था उस फिल्म में वो मैम का ही विजन था मैम का ही पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू
आप मुझे बहुत ज्यादा क्रेडिट दे रहे हो लेकिन ही इज अ वेरी गुड एक्टर एंड आई रियली होप कि यू नो आगे जाके आप बहुत ही अच्छी फिल्में करो और अच्छे रोल्स प्ले करो बहुत सारे अवार्ड्स जीतो
थैंक यू मैम मैं अच्छा एक्टर हूं शायद बट जो भी मैं इस फिल्म में हूं वो डायरेक्टर का जो एक नजरिया होता है उस कैरेक्टर के लिए वो जो भी दिख रहा है वो आरती मैम का पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू है मैं एक्टर हूं ठीक साहब Thank you.
Vivek, can I ask you a question?
Yes.
How was your experience working? आपने अभी कहा कि this is your first time that you have come up with a short film and you have worked with such great actors. How was that experience? Was driving rickshaw more for you or यहाँ पे acting करना इसके साथ?
अगर मैं रियलिटी बताऊं तो दर्शन सर को मैंने बहुत बार देखा है काम करते हुए. हम लोग जैसे हम लोग थिएटर करते हैं तो हम लोग जानते हैं थिएटर में कौन कौन बढ़िया एक्टर्स हैं, तो हम लोग फिल्में देखते हैं तो कहते हैं ये दर्शन सर है. तो दर्शन सर को जब मैंने मिला मुझे पता इनके साथ काम करा मैं थोड़ा सा शिवर करने लग गया था, थोड़ा सा नर्वस हो जाता है आदमी. बट सर ने सपोर्ट किया, सर ने बहुत कोऑपरेट किया, ताकि इनकरेज किया कि ठीक है करो. और कई बार तो बात बताते भी थे कि ऐसे करो अच्छे से रहो, नॉर्मल रहा करो, ज्यादा टेंशन लेने की जरूरत नहीं है, खुश रहो. तो उससे बहुत मदद मिली.
थैंक यू सो मच. एंड कैन आई आल्सो आस्क आरती, बिकॉज़ दिस प्लेटफॉर्म, ये जो आपने शॉर्ट फिल्म बनाई है, ऑब्वियसली दिस आईडिया समवेयर अराउंड केम टू योर माइंड, स्ट्रक योर माइंड, हाउ वाज दैट, हाउ वाज दिस बेबी बॉर्न एक्चुअली?
Firstly, I would like to thank Royal Stag, Barrel Select, Large Short Films for giving me this opportunity to be able to release this film online, which is in itself a dream come true. Had I released it on my YouTube channel with, you know, I mean, no fan base for short films, I wouldn't have got that viewership. We're releasing today at 7 PM and thanks to them, you know, there'll be a good viewership and it'll reach out to the audiences that like watching large short films. And mine is a musical, so it's a musical large short film. I don't think most short films have a song, you know.
Correct, we had a song as
I
well.
Had to, you know, have Kailash Kherji's voice and song in our film because it was so apt, you know, for the journey of Krishnakant Jhunjhunwala, his healing. And 1 year goes by in Varanasi. He actually thinks that he's going to die and, you know, he goes there for that, but then you know, during the song, you see his healing. That's why I use the song in the film. Sorry, coming back to your question. Yes. So how this baby was born, I'll tell you. I was looking for scripts along with a very dear friend of mine, Prakhar Khemka, who also studied with me at the New York Film Academy. He's 7 years younger than me and he's more like a brother to me. So both of us actually placed an ad on Mandy's.com. And we placed an ad looking for short film, come up with good scripts and get in touch with them. It was a very random, casual ad. And we got loads and loads of people that actually wrote to us, you know, that this is our script and this is our synopsis and all that. But there was just one script that we got totally, like, we were amazed with the story and everything. So we saw the profile of the writer and it was Vipul K. Rawal. You know, who had also at that time written Iqbal. And I'd loved Iqbal as a film. Nagesh Kuknur ji ki thi na Iqbal. So we met Vipul K. Rawal the very next day and he narrated the script, and at that point when he had written it, it was called Surat Nu Jaman Kashi Nu Maran. And we totally loved it and we decided that this is the film we want to make. Unfortunately, Prakhar could not continue being a part of the production and direction of the film, but I would definitely give him credit because we chose the script together. And then, of course, we worked on the screenplay and dialogues along with another writer called Sanjeev Puriji, who's also my mentor. And, you know, Vipulji, Sanjeevji and myself, we worked very hard on the dialogue, screenplay and the story of the film.
One more question for you, actually. Actors have a lot of experience, obviously. I wouldn't count your age, but yes, you do have experience. And I would ask you, Aarti, at such a young age, how do you relate to such a story and how can you put your heart and soul to it and make it so beautiful? How can you relate to the story, actually you especially?
I don't think it's got anything to do with age. You'll see very young directors making very deep films. You'll see much older directors making very, you know, films that are very light and chilled out and for the younger audiences. So I don't think this is a matter of age. It is your, you know, it is jo jis vatavaran mein aap bade hote ho aur jo aapko samajh milti hai while growing up. Like I spend a lot of time with my elders and my family. My grandparents have been a very, very important part of my life. And we speak deeply about life and death and, you know, all the deeper subjects of life that people don't usually talk about or discuss, you know. Those subjects that are supposed to be understood or read, but not discussed. So maybe because of that, you know, those conversations and all of that, when this script came about, you know, I really connected to it and I liked it and I thought that it was a story that needed to be told. In 2014,
when I heard the script, Prakhar and me went to Kashi, to Varanasi, to actually do a recce. And we were there for 15 days, just going to Mukti Dham, meeting Pandeji, you know, the guy who looked after Mukti Bhavan. And we would actually see, you know, dead bodies being picked up in front of us and how people checked in over there. Or if you don't die at Mukti Bhavan, you're asked to please leave in 30 days. This whole concept was just so, it was so unique. I mean, I've never heard of this, that Mukti Bhavan actually existed. And then there was a newspaper article also which said Kashi Karwat, the final halt. Kaise log jaate hain Varanasi, you know, marne ke liye, unhe lagta unko salvation milega, and what happens then? That's how, you know, I like the script, and I thought that it's a story that needs to be told. Yeah, thank you.
The film that you actually loved doing it. Anyone, choose one, you have to.
Well, that's a very difficult choice to make. There are many points in his life, even though it's a short film, you can, you see his entire life in front of you. Some happens in flashbacks, some happens in present tense. I mean, there are a couple of places where as an actor, I was supposed to just use my imagination, because it has not happened to me before. There is no emotional or sense memory of, you know, what normally actors depend on, emotional memory or sense memory to recreate certain reactions or expressions. But when I was, you know, when that scene where the doctor tells me that you are going to die, that was one, you know, for me a very tough reaction to make, because no one has told me this before. And I hope for many years no one tells me this before. But that was one very challenging. And secondly, to depict a man who is in constant physical pain and not really talking too much, but only absorbing and reacting to whatever is happening around him, is by itself a very nice and a challenging thing for an actor to do. Because there are many actors who sometimes choose the scripts according to the number of lines that they have. But when you have to remain silent for such a long time, and he starts speaking a little, only at the latter part of the film, and becomes animated also in the latter part of the film. Otherwise, he is a man who has seen death and he is waiting for it. So to do that was itself a very challenging process. Not a particular moment, but that entire journey of that man. And I must confess that I like to flash my dimples around.
But, those are lovely.
But in this character, the man was so much stricken by the reality of his death, approaching death, that he had forgotten how to smile. So I remember that first time when he meets that child, you know, who's mouthing those ancient wisdoms in order to make a living on the ghats. And that is the first time that he cracks into a small smile. And I had decided that till that moment comes, I'm not going to smile in this entire film. Even when I meet Sutariya from Surat, I am looking at him with a little bit of amusement and contempt, probably, you know, disdain. But I decided not to smile then too, because it was that child. You see, when you are confronted by this innocence, and that is the time you really feel like smiling. That's the time when his smile starts coming back. So, without really preparing for it, I must say that I kind of, you know, this entire process of this depicting this character was really very challenging to me. And it was an actor's delight. I mean, what better showcase you can have for a film than this. So, I do consider this to be one of my you know, ranking amongst my better performances. And yeah, and I remember when Aarti narrated to me the story. The story itself was something that takes your breath away, you know. You remain open-mouthed at the end. That what the hell happened? You know, it is that twist, a very O. Henry kind of a twist. You know, I'm a great fan of O. Henry's short stories. And this particular story had that very strange, but still there was a kind of a completeness about it. You are not feeling, you know, he has gone, he has come back from the jaws of death, and in fact the character tells him, you know, Rafiq tells him that now we are going back to life, so you know, get attached. And that attachment comes in form of Surat Ku Jaman, that he wants to, you know, that desire to live. As soon as it is, he experiences it, and then he is taken away from life, which is amazing. I mean, I wouldn't call this a sad ending. I would call this a very human ending, and this is how death comes. When you are least prepared for it, when you least want it, that's where it appears. And I think, you know, what Aarti said about to be understood and to be read, but never to be discussed. I think death is something that we should be discussing far often, more often than what we normally do, because that is the only thing which is certain in this life, and we just choose to ignore it. We all live as if we are immortal. But of course, on the other side, if you get depressed by the idea of death, then you won't be able to get up in the morning every morning. So it is that equanimity, that befriending the idea of death, is something that this film leaves you with. And that's why I'm very happy to have played this part. I mean, and of course, Aarti allowed me also to bring out my own interpretations, to contribute generally. There was a constant flow of, you know, opinions and dialogue between us, which also helped me, because I am an actor who wants to collaborate, you know, who just doesn't take orders, one who, you know, kind of wants to put in his own 2 minutes worth also. And Aarti allowed me that. Otherwise, sometimes, you know, when you are a first director, you have that very strong sense of what you want, and sometimes in that you miss out on many things which you would have probably, you know, had allowed to come your way if you would have kept the windows of your mind open. But in this case, fortunately, Aarti could strike that balance, and I very much feel that once you see this film, you realize that it is her triumph as a director, and as Vivek said, film is a director's medium. We are all making her film. So I am really happy to have made this film, your film, Aarti.
Thank you, Darshanji, again. I think it is definitely our film, and without the cooperation of my entire cast and crew, this would have not been possible. I was very lucky to also have Oscar Award winner Rasul Pokuti do the sound design of my film. And I had Kailash Kherji, who did such a lovely, brilliant song in the film. And a fantastic cinematographer called Inderjeet Bansal, you know, who was the DOP of the film. And overall, a lovely, lovely team, you know, whether, you know, I don't want to forget anybody, but if you'll have any questions, I mean, I could be open to answering them later on. But this has definitely not just happened because of me. This, I cannot take credit for this, because so many people have, you know, invested so much energy, time, you know, emotion into this film. And that is why I feel that this film has a soul of its own. And that is what was important for me, you know, because I just didn't want it to be very technically told. I wanted it to touch the hearts, you know, and a chord in everyone's heart. And that's what, you know, luckily is coming across now. Thank you so much, Ad.
Arti ji, right mein.
Solo malo?
Yeah.
Solo, solo.
Sir, Sir, the whole year.
Ma'am,
the philosophy of Banaras, you know, the fact that people go to Banaras to gain salvation, and the irony of the story that a man goes to a place to die and actually lives, and then he comes back to live and he actually dies. So I think the philosophy and the irony of the script attracted me to making this as a short.
And about the casting of the film, why did you find Darshan Shah the most appropriate actor to play the role and Rati playing the role of Rati? What was the casting criteria as such?
Darshan ji was my first choice for the role of Krishnakant Jhunjhunwala. I've been a silent admirer and a great fan of all his work, right from the days of Style to Ajab Prem Ki Gazab Kahani and all his other work. And his face, I think, is so versatile, you know, that he can do comedy, because I've seen him in most comedy films. But I honestly think that this role, I don't know, I just envisioned him playing the character, you know, the main protagonist role. And with great difficulty, I found his number, called him, you know, emailed him the script, aur unko pasand aa gayi, so I'm very, very lucky and thankful to him for playing this role, because he is a brilliant actor, and more than that, he's been very, very cooperative. And people talk so much in the industry. One thing I've realized, that never go by the talks of people, because they're always trying to pull down the people that are actually so good and, you know, such good actors. So I think that if not for him and his cooperation, this role and this film wouldn't have been what it is. And when it comes to Vivek, it's a short film, and I honestly didn't have a budget to travel with a whole, tolly of cast from Bombay. So, of course, Darshan ji, we had to fly to Varanasi to shoot. But I was in a situation where I had to choose an actor from Varanasi. And today I thank my stars that I was in that situation where I didn't have a budget to fly down a Bombay actor, because there's nobody who could have played the role of Rafiq as well as Vivek. And, he is also a theatre actor, and, he studied in Banaras.
Hindu University, Mass Communication.
Yeah, he actually does theatre in Banaras. And, you know, I, through and through, you know, during my Reiki only, I had started talking to people. Rajat was the guy who helped me, you know, look for locations in Varanasi. And I asked him, I said, I really want a good actor from here to play the rickshawala. And I don't want a rickshawala. I want an actor who will learn how to play the rickshaw to play this role. And he said, you know, I have this one guy, and, you know, you see him. And things just fell together. So that's how Vivek was cast. Or hum jab Varanasi gaye, we were hardly 4 or 5 people that flew down. The rest of the unit, you know, the main unit came by train. So jab hum jaldi pahunche wahan pe 4 din pehle, shooting ke 4 din pehle, तो विवेक को मिलकर हमने काफ़ी रिहर्सल्स किए, काफ़ी वर्कशॉप्स किए, मतलब पूरे दिन रेकी वेकी करने के बाद 10 बजे रात को से लेकर 12 बजे रात तक हम लोग सिर्फ बैठ के डायलॉग्स करते थे एक दूसरे के साथ। और फिर विवेक की और मेहनत थी, वो जाके एक्चुअली रिक्शा यू नो प्रैक्टिस करते थे। तो दैट्स हाउ विवेक वाज कास्टेड फॉर रफीक। Yes, of course. I would like to congratulate him on his national award for Rustam. In fact, Rustam bhi was written by Vipul K. Rawal, and Vipul K. Rawal is the writer of our film Mumbai Varanasi Express.
Okay. And Arjun, the topic of
Well, I haven't seen the film, but I know this much that my film was shot more than a year before Mukti Bhavan was shot. So I haven't seen the film, so I can't comment on it. But if there's any similarity, then they should be asked this question because they shot 1 year after our film.
How was your experience like
directorial debut? What is the difference between acting and directing a short film? Well, acting is my first love and it always will be. And I didn't realize, you know, I've been very spoiled as an actor. I've had a chhata on my head and someone to clean my sweat and someone to change my heels into flats. So I've been extremely pampered as an actor, and that's how an actor's life is. Of course, they have great amount of mehnat to do, learn dance steps, learn dialogues. I'm not taking away any credit from the mehnat that they do. But being a producer director was very tough on me because, you know, I had no perks. In fact, I played every role in the production at different points of the shooting. Even if I had to do the role of, you know, play the role of being a spot boy or doing something like getting chai for sir or, you know, holding a chhata for somebody in the unit, I would do it because that's how, you know, people would be comfortable. And I didn't want to, you know, I wanted to just leave behind the actor when I was focusing on directing and producing this film. So I was not bothered about the way I looked or, you know, anything. Even though people in Varanasi, being, you know, Uttar Pradesh, and I've done films with Govinda Ji, who has a great fan following in Varanasi, people would recognize me and, you know, come to take pictures, and that would be, you know, difficult for our shoot, you know. Herds of people used to come over, but then we handled it, and it's definitely, it's tough being a director and producer.
Internet is a very powerful medium. I have experienced that last year when I did a web series, Permanent Roommates. I have got a very different demographic as my fans. After that series, people ranging from the age of 11 to 14 are the people who are my biggest fans there. I think it is very good that such an attempt to make a film that is close to your heart, that is according to your own artistic temperament, and but for which if you do not have the necessary resources to give it a commercial release, and that too it is not in a format which is a feature film, then I think internet is the best medium. And I really must thank Royal Stag that they have taken up this gauntlet, and they are releasing good films, and all the films that you would like to see but you cannot go to a theater and see, they are the films that are coming to you. So, and as I said before, this is one of my best roles that I have done. And I do believe that more and more we are moving towards content that goes more towards internet. And I think it's a good thing. I have one international series also on Netflix, which is not commercially, you know, there is no theatrical release for it. So similarly, even this film is something that I am looking forward to. I mean, by and large, whatever that I have done on, you know, web-based content, it has been much more satisfying, and it has been much more varied and much more a challenge to me as an actor. So I do believe that this film will definitely also send a wake-up call to a lot of other filmmakers that telling your own story and telling it the way you want is possible, and you pour yourself into it and the results will be there.
Thank you.